out here every day.
Always wanted to catch a home run. You know, it's not going to happen inside. There's too many people. I came close a couple times, and after a few years, I finally figured out that it would be a lot easier to catch them outside.
There's about 15 of them.
We catch batting practice balls and home run balls. There's a group of half dozen of us that come out here quite regularly.
I've been doing this about 15 years now, and I've come to find 1,700 baseballs for a total.
They barbecue, they play catch.
Most people think we're a little goofy, chasing balls and whatever. No different than someone going out and fishing the way I look at it.
This is their summer. That's what they do.
When the ball comes, you know, it's free for all. That's how they get on game home runs. It's really a rush. A lot of us do it because we're crazy.
How many balls have you caught?
I've got around 500. I don't keep track like all the other guys, but I'm right around 500. I got 18 this year. I mean, I've caught a ball in 8 games, so I'm in a slump. Just kind of watch like that, watch where the ball goes. You'll know if it starts to come, the crowd will really take in. These guys will knock us over. It's almost a rush of, let's get another one. And then after a while, it becomes competition with the other guys. Who can get the most balls during the year?
It's not as easy as it looks, Carol.
What have you got for us, Eric?
Yeah, thanks a lot, Chip. Well, I'm doing some ball hawking this afternoon. I've been out here the last couple of innings, and I'm learning from one of the best. Dave Davison's been doing this for 10 years. Dave's got an interesting story about how he got started doing this.
After many years in the bleachers and seeing ball after ball go over my head and sail onto Waveland Avenue, I figured it's time for me to come out here and finally catch what I wanted, which was a Ryan Sandberg homer, which in 97 I finally got one, second to last career homer. So that was my and since then I've been out here.
And in total you have open...
We're going to be getting Kerry Wood and Ishmael Valdez, it looks like, back very, very soon. 3-2. Here's the pitch. Swung! Belted! Oh, baby! Look at that ball rocket out of here! Out onto Waveland!
Had to be the singer.
Diamondbacks.
Maybe Sammy's early problems stemmed from the fact that he was a long way from home. But at least in 1992, he got to stay in Chicago, traded to the Cubs, where he grew both as a man and a player.
This is America's number one sports station, WGN, Chicago.
Oh, they're dancing down in the Dominican today. Steve Stone, Chip Carey, from a windy Wrigley Field. 3 homers hit already today. That won 38 games.
There's a drive. Hammer deep toward left. There she goes. Number 58. Out on the Waveland.
We've talked about it for the last 2 weeks. Just about any time you make a mistake to Sammy Sosa, he hits it out of the park. He's now driven in 126. And it's Sammy who got what looked like an off-speed fastball. And he got it down. And how far did it fly? 395. Very close to historic feet.
That's right. Sosa just 2 shy of 60 now.
Yeah! Yeah! for 12 years. I played the street like I always do, in the middle of the street. Mo was in his usual spot in left center. The ball came out, and I had a feeling that Mo might have a chance at it.
Right, it shot over this way, went into a pile of people here. Everybody just knocked into each other and stuff. You know, I got here and the ball at the same time. If the guy didn't trip me up, I'd have been gone already. You see, so I got it on a clean breakaway, except for 1 foot. And the guy just reached out and tripped me up. And then the pile just came over. And before they even got on top of me, they just surrounded on the ground around and started ripping at my hands. You know, I mean, I couldn't believe it. The ball was totally in my hands by myself. And I had hundreds of people that just ripped at me. I was laying down, and then they just all spread all around from every angle. They were just pulling and jerking everybody. And then the pile got higher and higher. I couldn't even breathe anymore. It was brutal. Like I say, why was it?
Mo's the nicest guy out here. And damn it, if he said he had that ball, he had it. Because if he didn't, he'd pat the guy on the shoulder and say goodbye.
Now I know ball hawking is a dangerous job. You can really get hurt.
Baseball on WGN is brought to you by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge.
Time to have a ball with our Illinois Lottery moments. The Illinois Lottery celebrating its 30th anniversary. The Cubs having a ball today, whacking around the Cardinals. And a light drizzle begins to fall here at the ballpark.
Well, you knew it was coming. You just hope that the heavy stuff stays away until we safely get in the air, wending our way to Anaheim, where the Cubs will face the struggling Angels. And they haven't struggled.
Three balls and the strike. Two men are out. There's a long.
RBI's 106, 107. And Sammy takes it out down the right field line.
Yes. Sure. But I don't know if. I'm sure he will. You have to. I mean,
save your energy.
Yeah.
If you're able to pass it.
He goes the other way with this. Deep to right. Back it goes. No, 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 no.
Wow, that was an oddball, huh?
Well, I think it just shows you how strong he is because, I mean, that ball was in on him. He inside out down the right field line and it still hit it out.
It's like he highlighted out.
Yeah.
It was a regular rebote.
Oh, my goodness gracious. Back, back, back. It's over everything. It's out the window. The ball out there. Shades of Waveland Avenue, huh? Hit me. He did. How about that? Hit me, Sammy, and he gets the ball.
Wow. Well, he needs one more.
He almost hit the prop stand. Can't do that. Blake, no. And you know the color of his shirts that they're wearing in the National League, you guys.
The stadium.
Is this the last one, guys?
It's the one.
Oh, this on the street. Tell you what, that's pretty good reflexes knowing you can't see anything.
Oh, that's some torque.
Well, the one thing that they all have in common if you flip the bat away is you do not see any of them rolling their hands over. I mean,
nah.
All their bats, when they hit these home runs, in the perfect position. Kind of underneath it.
Babies go, open up the window, Grandma, because there she goes.
This is great. The guy gets it.
Yeah. Look at his shirt. After the game, Sammy clocked him right in the grill. Out. Tied at four. Sosa. Seven outs. Later, Opie. Playing the part of Jack Haley and ML Carr is Odalis. Carlos Perez. Watch it again. Swings, drives, late. Peace out, Matt Town.
Loses eight. Rick Aguilera will try to pick up his 24th.
Is on, and here is Sammy Sosa. Away to climax. His first victory of the year at home would be for Sammy to hit one out on Waveland Avenue. Sammy is 2 out of 4 with a run batted in. They've got 2 runs batted in. 2 men are out. There's a drive. Way back. It might be. It could be. It is. On to Waveland Avenue. What did I wish for? Holy cow. And the Cubs lead now 9-0. Listen to the crowd.
To swing a hot bat. He went 4-for-4 today, including 2 homers. He now has 17 on the season, but the Cubs would lose 9-5. And after the game, Mark Pryor talked about his injury.
To outside Wrigley Field, I'm Eric Collins alongside a little piece of Chicago history, Wrigley Field history. Dave Davison, one of the greatest ball hawks in Wrigley Field history. What's the count up to now, baseball-wise? How many do you have?
I got 68 this year so far, which brings me to about 3,800 on my career.
And a lot of these are game home runs, right?
Yeah, almost 200. I got 191 game homers.
And Sammy Sosa has contributed how many to your collection?
19.
All 3,900 of his balls that he's got are inside his apartment. Incredible collection. If you got $10 for every ball, that's almost $30,000. Chip Steve, that's a nice investment. Back up you guys.
Thank you very much, Eric. No ball.
Sammy Sosa's homers spike towards the 60 mark, and the crowds continue to grow. Head over to Waveland, where you are welcome, but you better come ready to play.
The ball hawkers are ready. Steve Traxel is warming up as the Chicago Cubs get ready to take out.
7-2 Cubs, one on. Mike Piazza hits a deep 2-run homer to left off Steve Traxel. On to Waveland Avenue. Another nice breeze from that one for the fans. His 21st homer, it's now 7-4.
On Bonds again, this time Steve Rame with the charitable donation. Jim Riggleman will get tossed in this one for the second time this season. Don't blame him for wanting to leave early. Cubs lose game. Sammy Sosa hit a home run, and pretty much all he's swinging for these days. In the sixth, he would connect. Number 52, that puts him one up on good buddy Mark McGwire. Cubs rallying the ninth, fall short. They get swept 6-5.
3-2, Cubs lead. Super outing for Farnsworth so far. The pitch. Swung on, there's a drive. And just like that, Cincinnati has the lead out on the Waveland. Greg Vaughn with 6 hits in the series, 5 of them home runs, and the Reds lead by a run 4-3.
And as you see, a short, quick, very powerful stroke.
The guys that keep, we'll get a call with all the guys that keep going down. The All-Star game. There's a drive. Hammer deep toward left. Look at that ball rocket. Down Kimball. Wow, a pellet by Frank Thomas. A solo home run. Cuts the Cub lead to 1. He's now, I think, 3 away. And would be the first Philly to do that. There's number 20. Way down the street. Down Kimball.
It looked like a breaking ball that stayed up in the zone. And for Glenn Allen Hill, his 20th home run in 245 at-bats. And there's a welcome souvenir. 53rd run driven in.
I'm sorry.
2019 season. And as you see this year, he's been hit very hard. 8 runs allowed in 9 innings of work. And Todd Walker, who's become very adept, Steve, at working the count in that leadoff spot, takes a ball outside.
Well, normally, Walker doesn't want to swing early in the count. He wants to see just what a pitcher has.
Y además debe de ser peligroso manejar por ahí, ¿no, Pedro? Claro. Ahí hay dos aficionados que no alcanzaron a entrar y se ponen a practicar varios.
Son varios. Es un partido que está jugando fuera del estadio, aficionados. Eso es muy común allá en Barranquilla, Colombia, la tierra de Edgar Rentería. Lo pudimos observar al costado del estadio Tomás Guardia, o Tomás Rivera, donde se hizo pelotero precisamente Edgar Rentería. Hay algo similar a lo que estamos viendo aquí. Los aficionados llegan a jugar pelota fuera del parque, en una vía pública.
Y este es bateador zurdo, ¿eh? 1-2 la cuenta para Jones. Roletazo dormilón, ataca en segunda base Morandini para Grace y muere en la combinación 43. Lo está dominando y lo está obligando a batear dentro del cuadro. Ahí está. Y llega un auto, Tienen que parar el encuentro.
Seguro.
Esto es lo pintoresco del béisbol en Chicago.
Andrés Galarraga bateando, tiene de 1-1.
El batazo elevado de Galarraga se está quedando dentro. Lo persigue Mieski. Está esperando Grace y Grace se queda con la pelota, capturando para el tercer out de la entrada. 1-2-3 seguidos. Vamos al cierre de la quinta.
Está arriba los 400 Morandini.
33.
Y los fanáticos en el Wrigley Field en su oportunidad.
Un batazo elevado profundo de Henry Rodríguez. Se está yendo. Se va. Cuadrangular. Abriendo la sexta. La bota. El de Santo Domingo. Su cuadrangular número 11.
Bueno, y es el cuadrangular efectivamente número 11 de la temporada para Henry Rodríguez. Amarra a un mar.
Ball, fly ball, hammer deep left, back to the track, Hubbard, it's gone, Andrews has tied it in the ninth.
Shane Andrews got a hanging slider, a 1-2 count, and hit his third home run of the year. He's driven in 8. And the Cubs behind all day long. Wait for their last at bat and tie it up. Shane Andrews with a bomb to left.
And finally, we cash in a break. The Braves walk 2 men leading off the inning. And Shane Andrews cracks a 3-run homer. And boy, you know, the weight of the world is off his shoulders for the moment. He felt terrible after that game in Cincinnati yesterday. He feels great right now.
And for Southwest Airlines, how far did it fly? 365 very happy feet.
Bobby Cox and the Braves hoping to survive to see a 10th inning. They were cruising right along, but Remlinger, Leitenberg have had their problems.
Reed, line drive, left field line, stay fair, it does, and the Cubs win. 4 runs in the ninth. Jeff Reed, a pinch hit single, and the Cubs shock Atlanta and win the home. 4-3, the final score.
Well, Chip, I'm really surprised he gave Jeff Reed anything too good to hit with 2.
Takes away from everything.
Well, yeah.
So here's Ramirez. He walked and scored last inning. It's deep into right field. You can put it on the board. A grand slam homer for Manny Ramirez. And it's 7-0 Indians. 3 walks, this inning, two last inning, five total, and they all have scored. Quite noticeably.
And if you can get into that pen,
you've got a chance.
That gives you a terrific opportunity.
Well, let's chip away here in the middle innings as we go to the fourth. It's Glenn Allen Hill who grounded out to third, and Jeff Cirillo his first time up. It's 3-0 Milwaukee. Boy, I wish these guys were back in the American League. Hey. They're not playing fair. Neither is Hill. He just hit a rocket. Look at that ball jump out of here. On the wavelength. No doubt about that one, folks. Number 12.
For Glenn Allen Hill, third in two games, third in less than 24 hours. So Glenn Allen getting a chance to play in this power-packed outfield. Down one zip.
So an unearned run charged to Lieber, who gave up three unearned runs in his last start against San Francisco. Here's Lieberthal. He struck out as well. Back in the second inning.
Well, I think I'd be pretty careful with Lieberthal. You've got first base open. And here's one of the hottest hitters on this team. You got Anderson in the on-deck circle. He's only hitting in the 230s. So don't give Lieberthal anything to drive.
And John misses outside. Happy belated birthday greetings to Frank Knack. Celebrated his 70th birthday on June 16th. Frank's had some health problems, but hopefully he's enjoying the ball game today. As is Harriet David Schaffer in Dubuque, Iowa. On WGN. There's a drive hammer deep toward left. It's long gone. A two-run homer. They gave Lieberthal something to drive, and he hit it a mile. It's 3-0.
Well, sometimes, Chip, you know, you have to take a look at who's real hot on a ball club you're facing, and when you have a chance to pitch around him with first base open, it's not necessarily a bad idea. But unfortunately, the 16th home run of the year and RBIs 53 and 54 have now put the Cubs down 3. And Lieberthal hit the daylights out of that one. He loves fastballs, and he loves them up. This is a hanging slider, but it's up, and it goes way out.
Amazingly, Steve, this guy hates hitting in Philadelphia. Lieberthal now 14 of his 16 homers, 38 of his 54 RBIs have come on the road, and the vet is a very good hitter's park. You saw it a moment ago. It's the same play, the Mike Lieberthal home run. As he said, a 1-0 hanging slider. The one pitch today John Lieber would probably like to have back, a two-run shot. The 16th of the year for Lieberthal. That provided the margin of the victory for the Phillies as they win it 3-2, our final score. Our next game here on WGN will come your way tomorrow. Note the airtime, folks. We're on the air and ball. He couldn't come up cleanly. That opened the door for a three unearned run inning. A hanging slider by John Lieber to Mike Lieberthal capped that three-run stanza and put the Phillies in front by a score of 3-0. Cubs came back, made it 3-1. Then in the bottom of the ninth inning, scored an unearned run of our own. Swung, belted deep toward left, and that is a three-run homer. Grissom does it again to the Cubs.
I gotta believe that Mr. Serafini will be in this game as Marquise hits his eighth home run. Seemingly all of them have come against the Cubs. He's now driven in 41, and he was struggling when the Cubs saw him in Milwaukee. He struggled after the Cubs left, but he's just decimated the Cub pitching staff.
Three home runs, 9 batted in the series. Swing and a drive, belted deep to left. Palu has hit a mammoth two-run homer.
I love watching that guy hit. I really do.
It's tough to sneak the ball by him inside because he's got such quick hands. And Arang finally got one that wasn't 6-8 inches inside. Tried to get it by him, and Moises hit it out. Fourth home run. He leads the team with 10 driven in. That fastball was supposed to jam a Lou. He was able to bring his hands in, get the good part of the bat on the ball, and take it on the wavelength. That would have been a home run any day.
And it's a...
How far did it fly for Southwest Airlines? 420 happy street feet. And the second one doesn't make it quite to the street, but equally effective. How far does it fly? 365. Very happy line drive feet.
It's playoff atmosphere on the north side, and it's only April. Today, Maddox looks to get back on track when he mows down Junior. Next.
Give him a break in ball now.
Well, he walked him when he faced him last night on the 3-2 count.
I guarantee you, if he throw him a fastball the first pitch, he's going to swing at it. Because he's looking for dead red right now.
Moises Alou, 1-for-3 today. He threw him a fastball, but it was well off the plate.
Outside.
You know, Felipe said, this is my kid. I know what he can hit. Don't throw him a fastball inside.
Well, he saw that last night, you know, when Alou beat him a ball game last night. That's really something, getting a chance to hit a home run to beat your father in the major league. That's really something. Well,
Chip said it's the first time it's ever happened.
Wow.
Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah. Well, that's baseball. A lot of things come up over the years.
One ball, no strikes. That one's lined out of play, foul.
That was kind of outside, too.
That was called the emergency hack, Billy. You never took too many of those, but that's what that was.
Well, you don't need to take emergency hack now because it's 1-1. You know, it was one ball. You don't need to take no emergency hack now. When he gets 2 strikes, he might. Yeah. No, let's. He might go to a slide piece now.
You guys should have paid to hit on a day like today. Warm, humid, wind blowing straight out.
Well, Ernie always said that. You know, I come to the ballpark and I'll play for free, but I didn't go for that.
1-1 count, way upstairs. Yeah. How would you have hit against Steve?
Steve had a great curveball.
Yeah,
a great curveball and a good fastball.
But the first time you saw it in this park, you took it out onto Sheffield.
Yeah, but, you know, you couldn't guess with him because he threw the 2 pitches and he got them both over. You just have to get him a fastball situation to swing the bat. Although sometimes you might look for a breaking ball because he will throw it.
Well, see, he was a veteran and I couldn't hit him. I didn't want everybody in the league to hate me.
So. 2 balls and a strike. Ooh. Way upstairs, Ramirez waiting next.
I will tell you a true story. They told me with Billy Williams, start him out with a slow curveball. Spring training, slow curveball, first pitch. He tapped it back to me with 2 men on. Got out of the inning. But he remembered that. I should have, because I started him out with a slow curveball with 2 men on, and he hit it on to Sheffield in the regular season when it really counted.
Yeah, that's nice. You had a nice breaking ball.
3 balls and a strike, great hitter's pitch.
Swing and a drive, deep left field. That
that back. That's the seventh game against St. Louis. And that ball's crushed by Bill Hall deep toward left field. And it is long gone out onto Waveland Avenue. Bill Hall has just hit a two-run homer for Milwaukee. And that was a no-doubt-about-it blast. Hall his first major league hit, a ringing two-run homer.
John, this is just a hanger from Joe. And all read it, and he knew it.
Nobody's throwing the ball back from the street, so Hall's not going to get the first major league hit for the trophy case. It might be sitting out in somebody's yard under a rose bush. So after the game, Billy, if you want to go try to find it, help yourself. Popped back by Thompson, who's 0 for 3.
Might have some teeth marks from
that dog.
Bunch of dogs.
Yeah, could be. My guess is the lab's got it.
Harry Carey and Steve Stone and the Dodgers have the bases loaded.
Three-game sweep this year against the Expos. Game was scoreless in the sixth inning. Jeff Passero against Doug Glanville, who'd never hit a major league home run until this. It landed on the avenue. Fights on for the souvenir out there, and the Cubs take a 1-0 lead. It was a Glanville kind of day all the way around, running toward the line, into the wall to make the catch in the seventh inning. But reliever Terry Adams was in there in the eighth. Moise Alou with a man on, and he was 3-for-27 before this at bat. But with one swing,
kidding. That was Jamie Navarro, the dugout comedian. Looked like one of those too-good-to-be-true days for rookie Doug Glanville in the sixth, and get out of here, his first career home run. And check out the guy in Waveland who grabs the ball out here coming up in a minute here. It's our new general manager, I believe, wearing the Fox shirt. It gets better for Glanny in the seventh. Little pop, and here he comes sliding over for the catch.
And Louie looks up at it, and it is gone. Jeff Codine, a two-run shot onto Waveland Avenue, and that gentleman caught the ball. I think he's going to have to throw it back. Oh, he had a Marlins hat on. I don't know if he'll throw it back or not.
Well, he'll probably throw one back, only it's not going to be the home run ball. And here it comes. Everybody giving him a hand.
Two-run shot, Jeff Conine. And it's now an 8-2 ball game.
Home run number 21, RBIs 74 and 75.
That wind blowing strong to the left field, so anybody's going to pull it. And here's the fan. Oh, they switched balls. They did.
The old switch ball trick. And you see the good ball in the glove, and he's going to throw back the other one. Boy, that's as surprising as Dennis not getting married.
Isn't it, though? The tradition, though, when the opposition hits a home run, even if it's right out of the ballpark onto something like Waveland Avenue, the tradition is to throw the ball back. Well, this guy right here, now, would you buy a used car from this guy? You think that's the ball he's going to throw back is the one that Jeff Conine, the opposition player, hit for a home run. He should throw the one that Conine hit back into the ballpark. But no, he's got Conine's ball in his glove. He switched balls with another guy out there on Waveland Avenue, an accomplice in the crime. And now he throws this ball back in and actually has a pretty good arm. We got to think about him. Real good arm, Stoney.
That is the...